Hello colleagues, so today we will be discussing a case of a 60 years old female who presented with dizziness for past few months. So now look at the ECG. What we can see on the ECG, this is more of a bradycardic rhythm. So whenever there are bradycardias, then you have to see two possibilities. First of all, we need to see that is it the disease of the AV nodal conduction system or is it the problem with the sinus node. So for that we need to measure some intervals and we have to see the sinus activity along with the AV nodal conduction system properties. So for that, let's start from limb lead 2. So what we can see is we can see a sinus P wave over here. Okay, so these are a sinus P waves. First of all, we need to identify is the sinus node firing or not. So by looking at all the 12 lead ECGs, we can see that sinus node is firing. So the next step is why there are pauses in this rhythm. Okay, we can see that every P wave is followed by a QRS. So when there is a P wave, it is followed by a QRS. And we cannot appreciate a prolonged PR interval to suggest a first degree AV block. The next is, can this be an atrianodal Venkebach or AV Venkebach? For that, we have to see whether there is PR prolongation or not. So I cannot appreciate a PR prolongation in this rhythm strip. So AV Venkebach is again not the possibility. And high grade AV block and third degree AV block is then out of the picture because we cannot see any P waves which is not being conducted or there is no evidence of AV dissociation anywhere else on all the strips as well. So the only possibility is now this can be because of some sinus node malfunction. So in order to identify the problem of the sinus node, we have to see some intervals. Now look at these intervals. So I have zoomed in the rhythm strip for you and there are some intervals marked as well. So if we can see that although the P is firing but there are some pauses in between, so there can be a sinus pause. You can say it is a sinus pause, that will be right, but there is something else we also need to look for. Because as we know, there are two properties of sinus node. One is automaticity and one is the conduction down to the atria. So the problem can be either because of the automaticity or the impulse conducting down to the atria. So whenever you see a sinus pause, always try to look for the problems of impulse conduction. So these are called sinoatrial exit blocks. So there are three types of sinoatrial exit blocks. But now what's happening over here? So we can see that the PR and PP interval is kind of getting shorter. So 960, the next one is 840 millisecond and then the 760 millisecond, and then there is no P wave unless a P fires over here. So this means the PP intervals are getting shorter. So what does this mean? So this means that there is Venkebach. So this is opposite to the AV Venkebach which we see on the ECG. In the sinoatrial Venkebach, one of the types of sinoatrial exit block, the PP interval will get shorter and then there will be no P followed by a pause and then the P wave fires. So the PP interval will progressively get shorter in each successive beats unless there is a drop beat and the cycle resets again. So this is a PP shortening which has been happening in this ECG. Now look at the RR intervals. So the RR intervals, again, if we can take into account two RR complexes in which there is conduction happening. So these are 1640 milliseconds from here to here. And the pause is less than that. So it is 1400 milliseconds. So this is again something important to note. I will discuss that in further slides. The diagnosis then is sinoatrial Venkebach. Always remember that try to figure out exact cause of sinus node dysfunction because it is important. Although there is bit of pause, but ultimately this was a sinoatrial Venkebach that was happening in this case, which was the cause of this sinus pause. So always be wary of impulse conduction issues of the sinus node. So as we have discussed previously, that sinus node features have two properties. One is automaticity and one is impulse conduction. Okay. What is sinoatrial exit block? It's a type of sinus dysfunction in which the impulse generated in the sinus node over here is not conducted to the atria, or there is a delay in it. The problem lies over here because the sinus node, either it is not firing or is it firing and then it is not conducting downwards into the atria. Be wary of these properties. Now let's discuss the ECG features which you can see on the ECG for the sinoatrial Venkebach. It needs to fulfill these three criteria. First of all, there will be a progressive shortening of the PP interval that has been happening in this case. The PP interval is getting shorter from 960 to 840 to 760. This criteria is met. The second is the P wave is blocked in the sinus node, which will not appear on the ECG. The crossover here suggests that we cannot appreciate a P wave. And then the P wave comes over here. This criteria is also met. Third point. The sinus pause ensues afterwards and would be shorter than two of the preceding RR intervals. These are the two RR intervals which are preceding, and this pause is shorter. It's very short. So it's around, you can say, 240 milliseconds shorter. This is a significant difference. This criteria is also met. This ECG fulfills all the criteria for a sinoatrial Venkebach. Okay, as it is a problem of a sinus node impulse conduction, ultimately issue with the sinus node function, and the patient is symptomatic because she is having dizziness. This lady requires a pacemaker in her case. This is a definite treatment for her.